I'm usually pretty critical of the media for what I see is as cowardice in not fulfilling the obligation that they have in this very important role as a part of democracy and making sure that people understand what is actually going on. Sometimes though, they can let us know what's going on and still be cowards. And so, look, I don't know who's to blame for this. I'm certainly not saying it's the author. I think it's far more likely it's an editor or a manager at Washington Post. So don't message the author. I'm sure it's not them, but there was this article and it actually contained fascinating information, okay? This is from the Washington Post. They say this October report, so they're looking into these different scientific studies of the effect of different policies on health outcomes. And they say the October report found that if all states implemented liberal policies on the environment, gun safety, criminal justice, health and welfare, labor, marijuana, and economic and tobacco taxes, more than 170,000 lives would have been saved back in 2019. On the flip side, if states went with conservative versions of those policies, there would have been about 217,000 more deaths that year, the equivalent of a 600 passenger airplane crashing every day of the year. That is mind blowing. The horror of the difference between these two slates of policies. And by the way, it's not all in the favor of the liberals. They say the largest projected number of lives saved, about 201,000 in a year, came from a more mixed menu of ideologies incorporating conservative marijuana policies. Because this is gonna be a shocker to people, but smoking marijuana can cause some health problems in the same way that smoking tobacco can. I don't think anybody disagrees with that, but anyway, here's the thing. That is fascinating. They've just revealed that hundreds of thousands of lives a year might be on the line going for conservative policies versus liberal policies. So why am I mad? Well, how do they present this to the public, who isn't necessarily gonna read the entire article? This is how they present it. Can politics kill you? Research says the answer increasingly is yes. Well, that's not technically wrong, but that's kind of hiding the point. Politics isn't killing you. Certain politics is killing you. One, parties aren't killing you. One party appears to have a good chance of killing you. By the way, it gets super clear. They say on COVID, in one study, researchers concluded that people living in more conservative parts of the United States disproportionately bore the burden of illness and death linked to COVID-19. The other, which looked at health outcomes more broadly, found that the more conservative a state's policies, the shorter the lives of working age people. So not only do more people die, but they die at a younger age. This is super clear, multiple studies across multiple different issue areas. And yet, you have to dig into the article to read what I just read for you. Do you want to know what you get in the first paragraph? As the coronavirus pandemic approaches its third full winter, two studies reveal an uncomfortable truth. The toxicity of partisan politics is fueling an overall increase in mortality rates for working age Americans. Again, that isn't technically inaccurate, but it hides the entire point of what you're talking about. Toxicity isn't killing people. Partisanship, extremism, these vague things that allow the Washington Post to distance themselves from what the studies are showing, that isn't what is killing people. Conservative politics, conservative politicians are killing people. When you say the division in American politics has grown increasingly caustic and polarized, but it wasn't always this way, how has it changed? Specifically in what way? They're giving us the actual information, but hiding what the takeaway should be from it, JR. So I apologize for going off on that. It's just they finally did a good thing. Why not actually promote it? Say what it is.
Because then conservatives, politicians as well, conservative politicians will say, look at the Washington Post with their slanted partisan article. Sometimes the truth is slanted and partisan. It doesn't mean that they're coming up with different realities. We've always said it. It's weird how, not we being the Young Turks or anybody, but it's obvious. I forget who originated it, but it's weird how reality and logic actually have a liberal bias, because that's where the reality is. When people make stuff up from the other side to get their political points across, those things just aren't real. And by the way, this whole mix of different things, the one part of marijuana policy being conservative, if that's mixed in, how many more lives would be saved? What's that based on? I don't know what studies they went through to get to that point, or whatever kind of processes they went to get to that 201,000 number. But what is conservative policies towards marijuana in general? I'm sure it varies between different politicians, but in general, it's punitive, absolutely illegal. If you're caught with it, you're going to jail, because they think that that keeps people from participating in it. Has that worked yet? By the way, if we do make it absolutely illegal and then people still do it, those health problems still happen that could come from marijuana use. You know what could help that? Some of those other policies like healthcare, access to it, where it's not a brick wall if you don't have the right kinds of funds for it, then that could actually save some of those lives that are negatively affected by the effects of smoking marijuana. But absolute punitive approach to this has never worked. That's why we keep doing it, fighting it over and over and over again. If you have a solution to a problem and it still is the problem, that solution that you've been working on might not be the right solution, but we'll still push it and we'll still say, hey, those conservative policies just might help. Why? In what reality? Not the real one we're living in, some other one that we made up.
I like your approach, JR, and I think we should definitely, you're diving into the actual way that things are being coded in the study. I like that, we should do that. I think the article could do more of that. But at the end of the day, that's not on the author of this article at the very least.
True.
They're presenting it, but but I agree. But this, like, if science is of any value, it's in helping to guide action based on the best available information. This should be one of the biggest stories of the year. This politics, two different ideologies or whatever. Although, you know, in practice, sometimes there isn't that much difference between them, producing vastly different outcomes for the people who are going to be ruled by them. But we treat it as a horse race.
Yeah.
We treat it as a thing of personalities. That's what it's about. It's about people living or dying, dying early, lives being cut short, suffering. Make it clear.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.